So what we're looking at here is a 2 or 3 day old burn.
Probably a day and a half.
Day and a half burn.
Friday night.
And it happened how?
Putting wood on a fire, tripped, and
fell into
the coals.
So what's baffled to us is, one, why didn't you come in right away? And two, how did you manage the pain for 2 days with these burns?
Well, the next morning it wasn't that bad, you know, I mean, it was burning, but it was not swollen up. It wasn't oozing anything out, and I put some stuff on it and laid in front of a fan with the fan blowing on it, elevated.
My goodness. Now, is this areas here numb?
No, you can feel that.
You can feel that? Okay. What about here?
Yeah.
You can feel it? Does it feel a little different than it would over here?
Yeah.
Less sensitive or?
Probably more sensitive.
More sensitive. Well, that's good, actually. So the problem with this kind of wound, one is nearly circumferential. It's not the way all the way around, but certainly puts them at risk of vascular injury. That's one of the things to worry about, that when people swell up too bad, then the blood flow goes bad. And sometimes we have to cut the skin open just to relieve the pressure. But because it's left this area without burn, it allows enough expansion for it not to affect it. But one thing I've learned about burns is whenever the physician thinks it's a grade 1, 2, or 3, it's always a grade up. You think it's a 1, it's probably a 2. This is This is obviously a 2 because of the blisters and possibly a 3. Now that we know it's out, two days out, it's a 3. The fact that you're not really hurting makes me think you probably burned the nerves underneath, which means that they're going to need to debri that, clean it up, and then maybe put some flaps of skin. First, they do like artificial skin, or they do pig skin or something like that just to cover it. And then they take skins from other parts of your body and fill it up to kind of like plugs on the grass, you know?
That piece up there was left on.
Mm-hmm.
I ended up cutting it off. It was like this right here, like that's not attached underneath it.
It burned
and blistered it.
Yeah, but you can feel my touching your fingers, right? That's not numb? That's great.
Well, I got a little bit of, it's like, because I'm keeping it elevated, I guess. Making it lose
and
a little bit of feeling.
The other concern we have, go ahead and bring it up, is this here, the redness. You know, it kind of stops about there. So we think maybe there's some early infection, although that might just be inflammatory changes, not necessarily infected. But then, of course, we're giving antibiotics, upgrade his tetanus, and then sending him to a burn center where they can do the debridement, cleaning up, and things like that. And that's the teaching points on burns and the grades of burn and the sensation, infection we talked about. So I appreciate you letting us record this. Thank you.